It's nighttime in the big city. A department store Santa sneaks a sip of gin. Mistletoe makes an old man sad. Eight reindeer land on the roof of the Abernathy building. It's Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
Beginning to look a lot like Christmas, and for the next couple of hours it's gonna sound like Christmas too. This is a special Yuletide Extravaganza edition of Theme Time Radio Hour, chock full of Christmas themes, holiday dreams, and jingle bell schemes. So get yourself some eggnog, put up some mistletoe, and sit back and relax, and leave the driving to me and Rudolph. We're going to start things off with two tenor saxophone players from Chicago, Tom Achia, along with Gene Hammonds. They put out this record under two different names. Maybe you have it as Swingin' for Christmas. My copy says Boppin' for Santa. Here they are on Chess Records, Tom Achia and Gene Hammonds. Achia and Gene Hammonds, Swinging for Christmas, and we're doing the same here on Theme Time Radio Hour, because Christmas is coming. One guy who knows that is Huddy William Ledbetter. He got the nickname Ledbetter while he was in prison. He allegedly sang himself out of jail, performing for Governor O.K. Allen in Louisiana, where Ledbetter was serving time in Angola. One of the few ex-cons who recorded a popular children's album. This is from that album, Ledbetter Sings for Children. Here he is with his madcap song, Christmas is a-comin', Ledbetter.
Christmas is a-comin', and it's a-jumpin'. Christmas is a-comin', and it's a-jumpin'. Christmas is a-comin', and it's a-jumpin'. Boy, it won't be long. Chicken crows at midnight on a Christmas day. Rooster crows at midnight on a Christmas day. Children get so happy on a Christmas day. Children get so happy on a Christmas day. Santa Claus coming, and he's coming. Santa Claus coming, and he's coming. Santa Claus coming, and he's coming. Boy, it won't be long. Santa Claus comes on a Christmas day. Santa Claus comes on a Christmas day. Children run and tell their pappy on a Christmas day. Children run and tell their pappy on a Christmas day. Little children get so happy on a Christmas day. Little children get so happy on a Christmas day. Don't forget it.
That was Hattie Leadbetter, better known as Leadbelly. Christmas is a-coming. And if Christmas is a-coming, and it's the fifth Sunday before Christmas, it's a day known as Stirrup Sunday. That's a day when it's considered lucky for everybody in the household to help stir the Christmas pudding and put on war paint. If you're a fan of Christmas desserts, make sure to stay tuned, because a little bit later on, I'm going to be giving you my recipe for figgy pudding. Make sure you have a pencil handy. This week, we start being heard in England, so we want to wish everybody a very Merry Christmas. And for the duration of this show, every time I use the word humor, color, or favor, I'll be adding an extra U. We're going to go down to Tobago now, where the Calypsonians come from. They celebrate Christmas down there, too. They have masquerade bands performing in the streets. Perhaps this next artist, Lord Nelson, was one of those masqueraders. Here he is, the uncrowned king of soca, Lord Nelson, celebrating a party for Santa Claus.
Christmas time is the time for giving. We learned that from since we're small. But from year to year it's the same old thing. Santa's coming to call. We always ignore it or forget it. This we know it's true. So this coming Christmas, let's all make an effort, get a present for Santa too. Let's trade in the old sleigh and the reindeer for a big car with a chauffeur, get a helicopter, because everybody loves their old Santa Claus. Having fun, Santa brought presents for everyone. But he had to squeeze to a chimney for Nicholas. What a horrible place to pass. Why not open your window or your front door, so Santa could bring his gifts. I find that climbing on a rooftop and coming through a chimney is a whole lot of stupidness. Move him from the North Pole, cause it's so cold. Give him an apartment with modern equipment. I made a butler, he deserved. Let us show our love to dear Santa Claus. Everybody drinking beer, whiskey and rum, post Santa ain't getting on. And his jingle bells, there old Santa goes wearing the same old red clothes. We should be ashamed, we should be blamed to treat Santa Claus like a brute. So let's chip in some dollars, take him to the tailor for a new continental suit. Take him out to a nightclub or a movie, get some fine chicks and give a party. It's time to chip in and do our share to make sure he comes more than once a year.
Oh yeah, let's trade in that old sleigh and the reindeer for a big car and a chauffeur. Lord Nelson, a party for Santa Claus on Theme Time Radio Hour. From Tobago to Detroit. Like a rock, the voice of Chevrolet, Bob Seger. Bob got his start in Ann Arbor, Michigan. Some people call Bob the poor man's Bruce Springsteen, but personally, I always thought Bruce was the rich man's Bob Seger. Love them both, though. Here's a real early song by Bob Seger and the Last Herd. captures the spirit of rock and roll and a little bit of soul sound and a whole lot of Christmas. Put it all together, sock it to me, Santa.
You know what, Pop?
What's that, son?
Christmas just isn't going to be the same this year.
Well, why is that?
Because Santa's got a brand new bag.
Timmy Santa from 1966 on the Cameo Parkway label, a young Bob Seger. He's got a list of demands for Santa. Charles Dickens is known for writing a Christmas carol, but that's not the only thing he wrote about Christmas. This is from the Pickwick Papers in 1836. Happy, happy Christmas that can win us back to the delusions of our childish days. That can recall to the old man the pleasures of his youth. That can transport the sailor and the traveler thousands of miles away, back to his own fireside and his quiet home. Far cry from Bah Humbug. Thank you, Charles.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Christmas time is a time for celebrating. But we still have to take a moment to think about serious things. And who better to tell us than the Staple Singers? They were God's greatest hit makers, and their message-oriented material, like Respect Yourself and I'll Take You There, were big hits. They did a few Christmas songs that managed to mix a serious message with a soulful dancing beat. Here they are from 1970 on Stax Records. The Staple Singers. Who took the merry out of Christmas?
Who took the merry out of Christmas?
Oh. People all over the world forgot about Mary.
We're busy fighting wars, trying to make it to Mars, searching for light and can't seem to find the right star. Oh,
searching for light and can't seem to find the right star.
Yeah.
That was the Staple Singers, Who Took the Mary Out of Christmas? A question you could still ask today. We ask the hard questions here on Theme Time Radio Hour, even if it is the Christmas holidays. One guy who took the Mary out of Christmas was Oliver Cromwell. He was an English military leader, politician, and dictator. In 1649, Oliver Cromwell abolished Christmas. He declared it to be an ordinary working day. Anybody caught celebrating Christmas was arrested. He considered feasting and revelry on a holy day immoral. The ban was lifted in 1660. Here on Theme Time Radio Hour, we'd like to celebrate Christmas year-round, no matter what Oliver Cromwell thinks. You've heard us talk about Charles Brown before, and I think it's actually against the law to do a Christmas program and not play one of his songs. This is one of the best. Please Come Home for Christmas, Charles Brown.
Bells will be ringing the glad, glad news. Oh, what a Christmas. Baby's gone, I have no friend. You wish me greetings once again. Choirs will be singing silent night, Christmas carol. For Christmas by New Year's night, friends and relations send salutations.
Charles Brown on Theme Time Radio Hour, the holiday edition, and Please Come Home for Christmas. 1985, the rough and rude Johnny Paycheck couldn't have come home for Christmas. He was convicted for shooting a man in Hillsboro, Ohio, and spent 2 years in prison. But before that, he was already a colorful character. He got his start with George Jones. He played bass and steel guitar in George's band for a long time and picked up a few tips about singing, it sounds like. His most famous song, which they actually based a movie on, was Take This Job and Shove It. But in 1968, he made a few Christmas singles and sings the heck out of them. Here he is during the popular holiday classic, Jingle Bells.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, over fields of gold, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing in a sleighing song tonight. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Well, a day or two ago, I thought I'd take a ride. Fanny Bright was seated at my side. The horse was lean and lank. Misfortune seemed his lot. He got into a drifted bank and we got upside. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, riding a one-horse open sleigh. Yeah, now the ground is white. Know it while you're young. Take the girls tonight and sing this sleighing song. Just get a bobtail bay, 240 for his speed. Then hitch him to an open sleigh and crack, you take the lead. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
That was Johnny Paycheck doing Jingle Bells, one of the best known and most recorded of all the Christmas songs. It was written in 1857 by James Pierpont, who originally wrote it to be a Thanksgiving song. It was so popular at his church during Thanksgiving season that it was repeated at Christmas time and caught on, and forevermore was known as a Christmas song. Jingle Bells was also the first song broadcast from outer space. It was kind of a prank. The Gemini 6 astronauts, Tom Stafford and Wally Schirra, were in space on December 16, 1965. They told Mission Control, "We have an object. Looks like a satellite, gone from north to south, probably in polar orbit. I see a command module and 8 smaller modules in front." The pilot of the command module, he was wearing a red suit. The astronauts then produced a smuggled harmonica and sleigh bells and broadcast their rendition of Jingle Bells. Who do you think gave them the harmonica? Mistletoe, which is like athlete's foot for astronauts, has its roots in the old English word missile, which like its German root means, believe it or not, dung. It was originally thought to grow from bird droppings on the branches of trees. Mistletoe was considered to have magic powers, and as everyone knows, any two people who meet under a hanging of mistletoe are obliged to kiss. Two people who stood under the mistletoe together were Jerry Mulligan and Judy Holliday. Jerry Mulligan was one of the most influential baritone saxophone players in jazz. Together, they wrote and performed this holiday song, It Must Be Christmas.
It must be Christmas. The trees are bright with Christmas colors that warm the winter night. It must be Christmas. I see the snow for me this year. How can I let it be Christmas? My Christmas must wait until you're here.
Mulligan and Judy Holliday. It must be Christmas, and it's beautiful. Judy was born with the name Judith Tuvum. Tuvum is a Yiddish word for holiday. She was the daughter of Jewish immigrants from Russia, and her first job in New York was the assistant switchboard operator at Orson Welles' Mercury Theater. She was a great actress, and supposedly was called before the House of Un-American Activities Committee and totally confused them by performing her famous dumb blonde act. She was the only person who was never blacklisted or compelled to name names.
Shop for Christmas now here at your favorite drugstore. Exciting Christmas gifts you'll see, and everything to trim your tree here at your favorite drugstore.
Well, one of the most exciting parts of Christmas is Christmas morning. The kids wake up and can't wait to find their gifts under the tree. Here's a song that captures that excitement. It's by Titus Turner. Here he is on the OK record label, Christmas Morning. Listen to this.
Well, in the morning, yes, in the morning, ooh, ooh, in the morning, baby, whoa, Christmas morning, everything's gonna be merry. Well, 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 oh, real, real tight. Well, when day break, baby, while. In the morning, in the morning, baby. Ooh, hey. Yes, everything's gonna be all right. Bright and early in the morning, baby. Well, I wanna kiss you, baby, underneath the mistletoe. When Santa Claus bring your present, your horn I wanna blow. Whoa, yes, Christmas morning, Christmas morning, baby. Ooh, yes, everything's gonna be all right. Bright and early Christmas morning.
Christmas morning, Titus Turner. He sang a few records, but he's better known as a songwriter. He wrote such classics as Sticks and Stones, All Around the World, and Leave My Kitten Alone. The Christmas song, or as some people know it, Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire, which you hear behind me, was written by the Velvet Fog, Mel Torme. White Christmas was written by Irving Berlin. He was very proud of this song. Irving Berlin struggled with writing a Christmas song. He stayed up all night writing it. And the next day he told his secretary, grab your pen and take down this song. I just wrote the best song I've ever written. Hell, I just wrote the best song anybody's ever written. That's pretty confident. Next up, a band from Riverside, California, called the Bell Rays. Poor old Rudolph. The tale of the saddest reindeer of them all. Written by the guitarist Tony Fate.
Oh, Rudolph, he'll never be the same. Spent all of his glory days playing reindeer games. Never found a woman to stand by and be true. Now poor old Rudolph. You fuck.
He had to go for all the girls, and it only goes to show there ain't no use in running if you got nowhere to go.
That was a song about poor old Rudolph, the bell rays. You're thinking, how come I never heard that? That's because it's a new record, but it sounds like an old record. That record's made, believe it or not, in the late 90s, and this group is still recording, trying out different sounds. They kind of mix soul music with a punk rock sound. Check them out. Google them. Rudolph wasn't even one of the original reindeer. It was added in 1939 because of a Christmas story that Robert May wrote. Of course, we all know the other eight reindeer. It was Dasher and Dancer and Donner and Blitzen, Prancer and Cupid, Comet and Vixen. And we'll be hearing more about them a little later.
I've got the Christmas spirit, feel like spreading that Christmas cheer. That's why I'm doing my shopping early this year.
Some people just don't have the spirit of Christmas. They think it's all about gift giving. So to be more honest, I think a lot of them think it's more about gift getting. Christmas is not about running around the stores, spending money, and trying to buy people's love and affection. But why am I telling you that? Bob Dorough and Miles Davis tell it a lot better than I could in this song from 1962, Blue Xmas.
Merry Christmas. I hope you have a white one, but for me it's blue. Blue Christmas. That's the way you see it when you're feeling blue. Blue Xmas. When you're blue at Christmas time, you see right through all the waste, all the sham, all the haste, and plain old bad taste. Sidewalk Santa Clauses are much, much, much too thin. They're wearing fancy rented costumes, false beards, and big fat phony grins. And nearly everybody's standing around holding out their empty hand or tin cup. Gimme, 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 fill my stocking up, all the way up. It's a time when the greedy give a dime to the needy. Blue Christmas. All the paper tinsel and the fal-de-ral. Blue Xmas. People trading gifts that matter not at all. What I call fal-de-ral, bitter gall. Fal-de-ral. Lots of hungry homeless children in your own backyards, while you're very, very busy addressing 20 zillion Christmas cards. Now Yuletide is the season to receive give and oh to give and ah to share. But all you December do-gooders rush around and rant and rave and loudly blare. Merry Christmas. I hope yours is a bright one, but for me it
Blue Xmas, Gil Evans' arrangement. Sounded a little bit like Miles' classic, So What? And everybody knows Bob Dylan. He wrote a lot of the songs in Schoolhouse Rock, and his song Three is the Magic Number was sampled by De La Soul. Xmas, the time when the greedy give a dime to the needy. Bob Dylan and Miles Davis, Blue Xmas. Christmas was abbreviated to Xmas because X is not the Roman letter X, but the Greek letter chi, which stands for the first letter of Christmas. The abbreviation became popular during the day when type was set by hand and when it was easier to put one letter to represent Christ than to spell it out. No disrespect was intended. We've got a song now that I'm not even going to introduce. I'm going to let somebody else do it. Johnny, come on in here and introduce this record.
Merry Christmas, everyone. This is Johnny Otis. In behalf of Little Esther, Mel Walker, and myself, we want to thank all of you for making us the number one blues and rhythm team in America. We also want to thank the disc jockeys who have made this possible by playing our records for you. In appreciation, we have just recorded a special Christmas blues. Listen, will you? But first, Esther and Mel, let's wish everyone...
Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas, everybody. And a happy new year.
You're welcome, Johnny, and Merry Christmas to you.
Christmas time is here, and my baby's so far away. Christmas time is here, and my baby's so far. Been so long since my heart was happy and gay. My dad is so far away, but I hope he's not gone to stay.
My baby, I'm coming home today. I'm gonna hold her close this Christmas and never stray away. Cause it's so sad and lonely when my baby's far from me. Beneath the Christmas tree. I'm gonna grab you Christmas morning.
Don't you ever let me go.
And by New Year's morning, baby,
I won't be blue no more.
So sad and lonely when my baby's far from me.
That was Johnny Otis, along with Little Esther and Mel Walker. You know, Frank Zappa once told me that Johnny Otis was the inspiration for his distinctive facial hair. He thought it looked good on Johnny, so he decided to grow one just like it. We're having the coolest of Yules here on Theme Time Radio Hour, where we know what Santa Claus likes to do in his garden. Ho, ho, ho. One of the great things about Christmas records is that there's all kinds. There's mambos and polkas, jazz and country. Everybody loves Christmas music. You can get people who wouldn't listen to country music the rest of the year to suddenly listen to a Johnny Paycheck record. There's all kinds of Christmas records, including beatnik records. On December 23rd, 1823, a very famous poem was published anonymously in the Troy, New York Sentinel. It was reprinted frequently, and eventually, authorship was attributed to Clement Clark Moore. Some people still question whether he wrote it. Whoever wrote it is one of the most famous and greatest of all Christmas poems. Of course, I'm talking about The Night Before Christmas. Here's kind of a beatnik chicks version from 1959. Patsy Ray and the Beatnik's Wish.
Let's go, Daddy-O. 'Tis the night before Christmas, and here in my pad, I'm cooling it, Dad. Not even a rotor moves. My nylons are swinging by the chimney with much care. But what I'm wigging for can't fit there. All the neighbor cats are knocking some Z's with visions, man, like wow, presents flying through their heads. And I sit here dreaming in my overstuffed chair of my letter to Santa, baby. Hope it got there. For I wrote him a letter a few moons ago and posted it northward through the crazy, crazy snow. I wasn't greedy as so many chicks are. No request for a TV star. I didn't ask for a trip to the left bank, man. Not even a mink to my poor little me. My wish was more simple by far, than even a wish for a pink jaguar. Go, yeah, 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 go, man. I didn't write Santa that I wanted to ring. Diamond bracelet, not even things that swing like Kenton or Basie or the freshman four. I didn't want a ringside at the hungry eye. But do I wish to be like a bird and fly real, real high? I don't want diamond watches or rings, no such things. I don't even dig all the high fives that swing and swing. Yeah, that's how I like it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I wrote old Santa for just one thing. I fervently hope the old cat will bring. So hours before Christmas, alone in my pad, I'm dreaming of morning and going real, real mad. Santa, bring me a man.
Hey, Patsy, that was great. I learned that in the coffee houses. Now here's the real deal. A visit from St. Nicholas. 'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from the bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. When to my wandering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them my name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, come Comet on, Cupid on, Donder and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. And dry leaves that before wild hurricane fly, when they met with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the house top the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys they had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples how merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings and turned with a jerk. And laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. And I heard him explain ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." This is Theme Time Radio Hour, where we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, a pocket full of money and a cellar full of beer. You know, a lot of people don't celebrate Christmas. Like my buddy Dexter Quinn. He's an atheist. You know what his favorite Christmas movie is? Coincidence on 34th Street. Here's a bunch of other guys who don't believe in Christmas. They're from Tacoma, Washington. They're on the Etiquette record label. And I think these guys are not unfamiliar with the song Too Much Monkey Business. Here the Sonics. Don't believe in Christmas.
Well, Mom and Dad said the good, so I did what I should. Hung my stocking on the wall, didn't get a thing at all.
Don't believe in Christmas. Don't believe in Christmas. Don't believe in Christmas. Cause I didn't get nothing last year.
Up late at night to see Santa Claus, right? Sure enough, don't you know that boy didn't show?
Don't believe in Christmas. Don't believe in Christmas. Don't believe in Christmas. Cause I didn't get nothing last year.
Well, tried to get a little kiss from a pretty little miss. She slapped me down, said the church mistletoe doesn't work.
Don't believe in Christmas. Don't believe in Christmas. Don't believe in Christmas. Cause I didn't get nothing last year.
Getting half tight, one hand will slap you back, the other one will take you down.
Don't believe in Christmas. Don't believe in Christmas. Don't believe in Christmas. Cause I didn't get nothing last year.
They're the Sonics, and they don't believe in Christmas, but they do believe in the power of the B3 organ. A lot of people think that's a farfisa. Well, you listen to that solo, and that's a B3. The Sonics. on Theme Time Radio Hour. I hope you're having a holly jolly Christmas and a rockin' new year. A lot of people ask what myrrh is. It was the gift the third wise man gave, and you don't hear about it much anymore. Well, it was a red-brown resinous material, dried sap of a tree. It was a healing salve that could be applied to abrasions and other minor skin ailments. It was highly prized in ancient times and worth more than its weight in gold. Pretty good gift. The names of the three wise men are Caspar, Balthazar, and Melchior. Three names you don't hear much anymore. Well, except for Balthazar. Another name you don't hear very often is King Stit. He was a toaster. And I don't mean he could put bread in him. I mean a DJ from down in Jamaica who would toast over rhythm tracks. He was discovered by Count Bachuki at a dance in Jamaica. Count Bachuki was knocked out by his spectacular dance moves and asked him to try his hand at DJing. King Stit was born with facial disfigurement, but instead of having that hold him back, he used it as a gimmick, calling himself the Ugly One after the popular movie The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. Crowds used to come to see if he was really ugly or not, but by the time they left, they didn't care what he looked like, they liked what he sounded like. Here he is, the Ugly One himself, King Stit.
From Negri to Marron Point, I wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year! Wow! Right on! Right on! Make your move, make your move! Feel your groove! Like I told you!
So good we might play it twice. That was King Stit and Christmas Tree, some Jamaican toasting. While we're on the subject, here's some toasts for Christmas time. a Merry Christmas this December to a lot of folks I don't remember. How about this one? A Christmas wish? May you never forget what is worth remembering or remember what is best forgotten. Here's one I gave last year. Be merry all, with holly dressed the festive hall. Prepare the song, the feast, the ball, to welcome Merry Christmas. Christmas, the day of goodwill, cold weather, and warm hearts. According to legend, Christmas carols got the name from events that happened in the year 1888. In that year, a young girl named Carol Poles went missing in London. The whole city went out looking for her because it was almost Christmas. People knocked on every door, but she could not be found. This is around the same time as the Jack the Ripper killings, so people were afraid to open their doors. The townsfolk would sing Christmas songs, so people would know there was no killer outside. Even with this door-to-door search, Carol was never located. But Londoners started calling these Christmas songs carols after the missing girl. From then on, the name Christmas Carols was used. Here's a traditional song that they may have sung back in 1888, but they weren't singing it this way. Here's Huey Piano Smith and the Clowns, featuring Jesse Thomas on vocals, with kind of an unorthodox Crescent City version of Silent Night. That was Huey Smith and the Clowns with their version of Silent Night. You know one thing about the holiday season? You get a lot of cards at Christmas. I was in the post office the other day. The woman in front of me wanted to buy some stamps for her Christmas cards. The guy at the counter asked her, "What denomination do you want?" She couldn't believe he asked her that. But she said, "I guess you better give me 20 Catholic and 10 Presbyterian." I not only get cards, I get Christmas emails. Let me read one of you. This one's from Lola Brizendine from Montreal. Bonjour. She writes, Dear Bob, first of all, Merry Christmas. Hope the holidays find you well. I've been listening to the show for a couple of months now, and I've been buying records by some of the artists I hear there. My friends have been teasing me because they've never heard of these artists. I'm starting to feel bad. What should I do? Well, Lola, there's no reason to be ashamed. I like People magazine as much as the next guy, but there is a world outside of it. Don't be afraid not to follow the herd, because where the herd's gone, all the fruit is already eaten. I applaud you and have the happiest of holidays. Coming up next, Brave Combo. They say their mission is to expand the musical tastes of their listeners. We have the same mission here on Theme Time Radio Hour. Here's Brave Combo and a children's song, Must Be Santa.
Who's got a beard that's long and white?
Santa's got a beard that's long and white.
Who comes around on a special night?
Santa comes around on a special night.
Special night, beard that's white. Must be Santa, must be Santa, must be Santa, Santa Claus. Who wears boots and a suit of red?
Santa wears boots and a suit of red.
Who wears a long cap on his head?
Santa wears a long cap on his head.
Cap on head, suit that's red. Special night, beard that's white. Red cherry nose.
Santa's got a big red cherry nose.
Who laughs this way? Ho ho ho.
Santa laughs this way. Ho ho ho.
Ho ho ho. Cherry nose. Cap on head. Suit that's red. Special night. Beard that's white. Must be Santa. Must be Santa. Must be Santa. Santa Claus.
Hey, yeah. Look out, Santa. He's coming this way.
Come our way.
Your very animated Brave Combo. They're so animated that they made an appearance in 2004 as cartoon characters on The Simpsons. I was talking to Matt Groening. He's the guy that created The Simpsons. We got to talking, and this is what he had to say.
The thing with The Simpsons is generally we try to get iconic names like the Rolling Stones and Paul McCartney and Ringo Starr and so on and so forth. And if we can't get them, we make fun of them. So, but anyway, I'd been determined to get Brave Combo on the show for years and finally was able to do it. We had him play at the Simpsons 200th episode party. That was almost 200 episodes ago. In fact, that reminds me, we got to hire him for the 400th episode party, which is coming up at the end of this season.
In the 1950s, America got mumbo fever. Yeah! Bands like Machito, Tito Rodriguez, and Tito Puente popularized the dance craze that swept the entire country. It became so popular that they made jokes on TV shows like The Honeymooners.
What's so terrible about learning to do the mambo? Everybody does it now.
Everybody does it, Alice?
I don't know anybody does the mambo. I don't do it. Norton doesn't do it. My grandmother never did it!
Musicians like Earl Garner, Charlie Parker, Sonny Rollins, and Sonny Stitt all recorded mambos. It even made it into the world of rock and roll, like on this record by the Enchanters. From 1957, Coral Records, where they're encouraging the fat man from the North Pole to do the mambo. Mambo, Santa, mambo.
They have Christmas out in Mexico, a lot of places that you wanted to go.
Here's somewhere you don't know.
Santa's gonna do the mambo.
Santa's doing the mambo this Christmas. Santa's doing the mambo this Christmas. Santa's doing the mambo this Christmas. Mambo, Santa, mambo.
Mambo, Santa,
mambo. Mambo, Santa, mambo.
Santa with his eight reindeer, they come every time about this year. Here's something that you don't know.
Santa's gonna do the mambo. Mambo, Santa, mambo.
Until you got a
mambo, Santa, mambo.
Tell your mama,
mambo, Santa, mambo. Mama, mambo, if you can.
Time about this year. Here is something that you don't know.
Santa, mambo. Mambo, Santa, mambo.
But you got a
mambo, Santa, mambo.
Call your mama,
mambo, Santa, mambo. Mama, mambo, if you can.
Mama, mambo, if you can.
Mama, mambo, if you can.
Mambo, Santa, mambo. The Enchanters. Before Pope John Paul II's January 1998 visit, Fidel Castro, as a show of goodwill, gave Cubans the day off for Christmas for the first time in nearly three decades. He had originally canceled the holiday, hoping that an extra day of work would help bring in a record sugar harvest. It didn't help enough, and he never brought Christmas back for nearly three decades. Right now, we'd like to say Feliz Navidad to all of our Cuban friends. Celia Cruz, a Cuban salsa singer who spent most of her career in New Jersey, but was one of the most popular Latin singers in history. Here she is, along with La Sonora Montancera, performing Fiesta de Navidad. I believe that's Christmas party.
Avívate.
was Celia Cruz with La Sonora Matancera and Fiesta de Navidad. We got a lot more music to play ya, but I think it's important to take a moment out to talk about a little more serious things, like this poem, Christmas Bells by Longfellow. I heard the bells on Christmas Day their old familiar carols play, and wild and sweet the words repeat of peace on earth, goodwill to men. And thought how, as the day had come, the belfries of all Christendom had rolled along the unbroken song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. Till ringing, singing on its way, the world revolved from night to day, a voice, a chime, a chant sublime of peace on earth, goodwill to men. Then from each bleak, accursed mouth, the cannon thundered in the south, and with the sound the carols drowned of peace on earth, goodwill to men. And in despair I bowed my head, there is no peace on earth, I said, for hate is strong and mocks the song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. Then pealed the bells more loud and deep, God is not dead, nor doth he sleep. The wrong shall fail, the right prevail, with peace on earth, goodwill to men. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, Yuletide poet.
Hi, this is Stephen Wright wishing you a Merry Christmas on Theme Time Radio Hour.
Christmas is a happy time, but sometimes you can't help but have the blues. And if you do, you can't do any better than listening to Hop Wilson. Here he is, from Graveland, Texas, Hop Wilson, with his classic, Merry Christmas, Darling.
Merry Christmas, baby.
On the steel guitar. You don't hear much about him because he didn't record much and he hated touring. Hop was telling us all about the snow falling. I know what he's talking about. Looking out the window here, I can see the city's blanketed with snow. I hear that Samudio International Airport is socked in, so you got no choice but to stay home and listen to a little bit of holiday cheer on Theme Time Radio Hour. Just because it's cold here, and I do mean cold, there's icicles hanging down from every window, it doesn't mean you can't listen to records that come from a warmer place. They celebrate Christmas in many places of the world, like Frenchtown, a poor area of Kingston, Jamaica. Here's one of the prime movers and shakers in Rocksteady, the music that kind of came between ska and reggae. His name is Alton Ellis, and he leads a band called the Lipsticks. And he's going to tell you all about Merry, Merry Christmas.
Alton!
Oi, oi, oi.
Who am I doing this?
Oh, 5 o'clock in the morning, come wake up. I man don't have no money. I man don't mind paying the rent. I man broke. It's Merry Christmas. I gone.
Have some fun. Look. Sing. A merry, merry Christmas. Sing. A merry, merry Christmas. Oh, 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 oh.
That was Alton Ellis and the Lipsticks. Merry, Merry Christmas. If you're spending Christmas in Jamaica, you might see Santa riding a cart and a donkey. While we're on the subject of Santa, let's grab another email. This one comes from Monique Van Dorp. She's writing from Holland. She writes, "Dear Theme Time, a friend of mine sent me CDs of your show. I enjoy it greatly. I hear you're doing a Christmas show. Here in the Netherlands, we call Santa Claus Christman. I was wondering if you knew what they call Santa Claus in some other countries. Happy holidays, and if you ever come to Holland, look me up." Well, thanks, Monique. Don't be surprised if I come knocking on your door sometime. Well, Santa isn't known around the world, and here's what they call him in some different places. In France, he's known as Père Noël. In Italy, he's La Patagna, Father Christmas in England. That's pretty simple. In China, he's called Shangdan Narin. And in Finland, he is known as Jalupuki. Whatever you call him, he knows if you've been naughty, and he knows if you've been nice.
Hey, Santa Claus!
Yes?
Don't forget us grown-ups at Christmas!
You know, Santa has to visit 350 million children in 100 million homes all around the world. That's about 880 visits per second. Holy moly. Here's a song by one of the dreamiest about the merriest, June Christie.
I'd like to fix this bag of tricks and hand them out with a fleeting greeting. Smiles for the frowners, salutes to the uppers, boosts for the downers. May the day be the bowl of cherriest, and to all the merriest, hope you swing during the season. Hope the days go great, hope you find plenty of reason the whole year long to celebrate. Sun for the mopers, a laugh for the criers, luck to the hopers, to the strange and the ordinariest. Me to you, the merriest. Thoughts for the muses, a cheer for the winners, break for the losers, to the beats and the debonairiest. Greetings like the merriest. Hope there's oil under your rose vine. Hope you get that raise. Hope you hope everything goes fine the next 300 and some odd days. Friends for the loners, a song for the singers, grins for the groaners, make the day nothing can compare it. Have the most, the merriest. Have the most, the merriest.
That was June Christie saluting the uppers and boosting the downers, wishing you all the merriest.
Santa has to travel to many different places and visit many children of many, many races. You'll learn about these places and the kids from other races on the Christmas Travelogue.
Here's how you wish Merry Christmas to people from other parts of the world. You'll have to forgive my mispronunciation because I don't speak them like a native, but it's the thought that counts. For example, if you're in Hungary, you can say Bulldog Karasquanta. If you're in Korea, you say Sangtan Chaka Kuwait Muboni Chrisman. That's pretty close. If you're in India, say Shubh Christu Jayanti. That might get you there. In Ireland, of course, it's No Leg Shona Dweet. Oh boy, we're going to get emails on these. If you're in Malta, just say Il Milide Tu Jeb. Mexico, of course, Feliz Navidad. If you're in Norway this Christmas, Gledelig Jul. And if you're in Bakersfield, California, you can just say Merry Christmas, and Red Simpson might be there to say it right back to you. He was one of the architects of the Bakersfield sound. In 1965, Capitol Records' Ken Nelson was looking for someone to record songs about the new trucking craze. His first choice was Merle Haggard. Merle wasn't interested. But Red Simpson was hungry, and he agreed to do it. He recorded Roll Truck Roll. It became a top 40 hit, and Red was on his way to become one of the top singers of truck driving songs. Red, can you tell us about this next song?
This next song is about a trucker who hauls Christmas trees every year, and I think he has just about as much fun as old Santa Claus.
Red, Merry Christmas to you.
I'm trucking trees for Christmas from this old mountaintop. I'm trucking them down to the middle of town from that big Christmas lot. Yeah, I'm trucking trees for Christmas, singing jingle bells on my way. I'm trucking trees for Christmas Day. Well, you'll find me trucking Christmas trees to town every year. And I feel like Santa's helper, spreading a little good cheer. Cause the kiddies have been waiting for this season all year long. For Christmas trees and old Saint Nick to brighten up their home. So I'm trucking trees for Christmas from this old mountaintop. I'm trucking them down to the middle of town, to that big Christmas lot. Yeah, I'm trucking trees for Christmas, singing jingle bells on my way. I'm trucking trees for Christmas Day. I got a string of pretty Christmas lights hanging from the cab of my truck, and a little tree on my dashboard that I decorated up. Well, people may think I'm crazy by these silly things I do, but I don't care, cause I think The trucks like Christmas too. So I'm trucking trees for Christmas from this old mountain top. I'm trucking them down to the middle of town, to that big Christmas lot. Yeah, I'm trucking trees for Christmas, singing jingle bells on my way. I'm trucking trees for Christmas, for Christmas Day. Yeah, I'm trucking trees for Christmas, for Christmas Day.
That was Red Simpson. He's trucking trees for Christmas. Right now, Red's not the only one who has to work on Christmas. Other people who have to work on Christmas include policemen, firemen, bus drivers, subway and train operators, doctors and nurses, priests and pilots, waiters and cooks, and jail wardens. Most prisons make Christmas an extra visitation day, and prisoners are allowed to make a phone call. Prisoners are not allowed to decorate their cells, but generally the cell block has a Christmas tree. To all of our friends listening in behind bars, we know you've made mistakes. We're sorry you have to be there. But Merry Christmas to all of you from all of us here at Theme Time Radio Hour. Coming up next, the youngsters. They all met at Manual Arts High School on Vermont Street, Los Angeles, in 1955. A year later, they put out the sad tale of Christmas in Jail. Here are the youngsters.
Christmas in jail, Christmas in jail, had a little too much to drink. Ain't got no bail, ain't got no bail, and I'm spending New Year's Eve in the clink. I was in the wrong lane, feeling no pain, souped my car to 75, ran right into They're singing down the street while everybody's having Christmas turkey. They give me bread and water to eat. Christmas in jail, Christmas in jail. Wore my shoes out pacing the floor. Got rocks in my head, I wish I was dead. Ain't gonna drink and drive no more.
Christmas, Happy New Year.
They're singing down the street while everybody's having Christmas turkey. They give me bread and water to eat. Christmas in jail, Christmas in jail. Wore my shoes out pacing the floor. Got rocks in my head, I wish I was dead. Ain't gonna drink and drive no more. Drink and drive no more.
Yeah.
Ain't gonna drink and drive no more.
Merry Christmas!
Hi, this is Barry White. Make sure you have a safe and happy holiday. Please remember, don't drink and drive.
This is our Christmas show, wishing you more happiness than all my words can tell. Not just alone for Christmas, but for all the year as well. One of the most popular features on Theme Time Radio Hour is the double entendre, the song that says one thing and maybe means another. This one skates dangerously close to being a single entendre. Here's Gay Martin and her bodyguards, and I want a casting couch for Christmas.
I want a casting couch for Christmas, one to call my very own. One on which a girl could retire with an occasional piece in front of the fire. So Santa, don't you be a grouch. Please send me a casting couch. I've been in nearly every agent's office. I've been to Hollywood and back. My trouble isn't always falling arches. It's my aching sacroiliac. I want a couch to call my own. I've come to this decision. The only wrestling that I'd see would be on television. I want a casting couch for Christmas. One to call my very own. One that felt real soft to my skin. And I could even get a little practice in. 'Cause I don't wanna be a slouch on anybody's casting couch. My manager's apartment's really soundproof. Believe me, you can't hear a single word. Because he's working on a special theory that girls should be obscene and not heard. One agent had an office that really was appealing. He even had a movie script projected on the ceiling. I want a casting couch for Christmas. One to call my very own. My dressing room should be gold starred. So I'll take on all comers with no hose barred. So Santa, on this I'll vouch. If you'll bring me a casting couch, you'll be surprised how far it gets you. If you show a Jew some jitsu on a casting couch.
Come on over here to my casting couch. That was Kay Martin and her bodyguards talking about her aching sacroiliac. She wants a casting couch for Christmas. Kay Martin played in a lot of hotel lounges. Our paths crossed more than once when I was on the road. She's a fine performer. Always put on a good show. Early in the show, I told you all to go get a pencil. Why are you going to use it now? I got a lot of letters asking about this. Here's my recipe for figgy pudding. Figgy pudding originated as a porridge in the Middle Ages. In the 16th century, it became known as plum pudding. Now we call it figgy pudding, and here's how I make it. First, get 4 ounces of plain flour, a pinch of salt, just a pinch, 4 ounces of breadcrumbs, 4 ounces of shredded suet, 1 teaspoon of mixed spice, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 3 ounces of dark soft brown sugar, 8 ounces of chopped dried figs, finely grated rind and juice of 1 lemon, 2 tablespoons of milk, and 2 beaten eggs. Sift the salted flour together, then mix with all the remaining dry ingredients. Add the figs, lemon rind and juice, milk and beaten eggs, and then beat them well. The mixture should have a soft dropping consistency. Put into a greased 2-pint pudding basin, cover securely, and steam for 3 hours. I like it served with heated golden syrup topping and a generous pouring of custard. Makes me hungry just talking about it. My engineer Tex Carbone likes vanilla ice cream on it. I don't understand that at all. Enjoy it and have a happy holiday.
Ho, ho, ho! A Merry Christmas, girls and boys. I'm on my way with lots of toys to all you kids from 2 to 92. Merry Christmas!
I don't need to tell you anything more about Sonny Boy Williamson. We played him a lot on Theme Time Radio Hour. Here's Sonny Boy with his hands in his baby's dresser drawer. And you wouldn't believe what he's trying to find.
My baby was shopping yesterday, so I'm gonna buy what you need for Santa Claus. My baby was shopping yesterday, so I'm gonna buy what you need for Santa Claus. I'm gonna take mine with me, but I'll leave your horn and my dresser drawer. So that starts me to rambling, looking in all of my baby dresser drawer. Wow, that started me to rambling, looking all in my baby dresser drawer. Trying to find out what did she bought me for Santa Claus. When I pull out the bottom dresser drawer, the landlady got mad and called the law. When I pull out the bottom dresser whistle draw. The landlady got mad and called the law. I was just trying to find what did she bought me for Santa Claus. The police walked in and caught me on the shoulder. What you doing with your hand in that woman's dresser drawer? And the police let my baby broke me. Sean, why should I find my Santa Claus? I just kept on pulling out all of my baby's dresser drawer. I walked out, let the police land it arguing. She look at the man and pull out all the ladies' dresser drawers. Yes, I walked out, left the police and the landlady arguing. She look at the man and pull out all the ladies' dresser drawers. But he said, I got the letter to show the judge. The boy just trying to find his Santa Claus. Oh, yeah.
That was Sonny Boy Williamson trying to find his Santa Claus, just like all of us. You're listening to Theme Time Radio Hour, your home for holiday dreams, themes, and schemes. Ross Bagdasarian was a piano player, songwriter, actor, and record producer. His first big hit was a song recorded by Rosemary Clooney called Come Out of My House, which he wrote with his cousin, the novelist William Savoyan. Under the name David Seville, he had a number one hit with the song The Witch Doctor, which was the first record he made that featured the sped-up voices that would soon make him very famous. The Chipmunks were named after the executives of the record label they were on, Liberty Records. They were named after Alvin Bennett, who was the president, Simon Waronker, the founder and owner of the label, and Theodore Keep, the chief engineer. These records were made by taking vocals, sung at a normal speed, and then sped up. Singers had to overly enunciate the words so they would be clear once they were sped up. Give a listen to what the Chipmunks sound like at a normal speed.
We can hardly stand the weight. Please, Christmas, don't be late.
Freaky, huh? You can see Ross Bagdasarian in Alfred Hitchcock's Rear Window, where he plays the obsessed piano player who lives across the alleyway from Jimmy Stewart. Well, inevitably, Christmas comes to a close, and that means around the corner is New Year's Eve.
There's a new little guy who's coming your way. He's the new year. Yes, sirree. He's full of promise. So each doubting Thomas, beware. It's going to be a swinging affair.
Coming up next on Theme Time Radio Hour, you're the Cool Breezes. What a great name, with their song Hello, Mr. New Year. People love making Christmas records, and New Year's records for that matter, because you can guarantee sales-boosting airplay every year. I don't know if the Cool Breezes got played every year, but we're going to certainly play them this year. Say hello to Mr. New Year with the Cool Breezes.
Hello,
hello,
Mr. New Year, hello. Oh, yes, we welcome you here. We'll wipe our tears of yesterday, for a new year has come our way. It's true, Mr. New Year, it's true. The love we see through you will fill our imagination and give us inspiration. This is the reason why we make resolutions, and this is the season to give more contributions. Hello, Mr. New Year, hello. Oh yes, we welcome you here. will wipe out tears on yesterday, for a new year has come our way. This is the reason why we make resolutions, and this is the season to give more contributions. Hello, Mr. New Year, hello. Oh, 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 yes, we welcome you here. We'll wipe our tears on yesterday, for a new year has come our way.
That was the Cool Breezers. Hello, Mr. New Year. How's Mrs. New Year?
This is Ellen Barkin wishing you Merry Christmas on Theme Time Radio Hour. And have a Happy New Year.
They celebrate New Year's all over the world. And our next performer hails from Soweto, South Africa. Her name's Mabel Mafuya, and she sings a style known as jive. Not the kind of jive like Slim Gaylord, but more of a Morabi style. Sort of like South African ragtime. It's heavily influenced by American jazz, but originally Morabi was played on pianos with accompaniment from pebble-filled cans. By the 30s, it incorporated new instruments, like guitars, concertinas, and banjos. New kinds of marabis sprang up, including a marabi swing fusion called African Jazz and Jive. Here's a great example of it. Mabel Mafuya, Happy Christmas, Happy New Year.
Tell your father Happy New Year. Tell your mother Happy Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Tell your mother Happy New Year. Tell your father Happy Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Tell your mother Happy New Year. Tell your father Happy Christmas. Happy. Tell your mother Happy New Year. Tell your father Happy Christmas. Happy New Year. 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 Happy Christmas. Tell your father Happy New Year. Tell your mother Happy Christmas. Tell your father Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Happy New Year.
Tell your father Happy New Year. Tell your mother Happy Christmas. Tell your father Happy New Year. Tell your mother Happy Christmas. Tell your father Happy New Year. Tell your mother Happy Christmas. Tell your father Happy New Year. Tell your mother Happy Christmas.
Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Tell your father Happy New Year. Tell your mother Happy Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Happy New Year. Happy Christmas. Tell your mother Happy New Year. Tell your father Happy Christmas.
Happy, 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 happy.
The happy and jubilant, fantastic Happy Christmas, Happy New Year. That was Mabel Mafuya from 1958 on the Troubadour label out of South Africa, exclusively on Theme Time Radio Hour. We cover the globe. The holiday season is a time for joy. However, we'd be remiss if we didn't take a moment to talk about the holiday blues. It can be a time of loneliness and sadness. And let me tell you, if you got the holiday blues, if you got any kind of blues, I feel for you. I know life is hard, but you don't need anyone to tell you how to feel better. You don't need Dr. Phil. You don't need Tony Robbins. You don't need any of those people on television, any of those people in magazines. You especially don't need me. I'm going to tell you the magic formula. What you got to do is go out and help someone more unfortunate than you. Go to an orphanage, play football with the kids, go to retirement homes, go to soup kitchens, go into prisons, go see some people. There's people everywhere who aren't as well off as you. No matter how bad you have it, somebody got it worse. Instead of adding to the sadness in the world, why not lend a hand, help somebody out, and not just on Christmas? Why don't you give it a try year-round? All right, that's enough preaching. Let's play a couple more New Year's songs before we got to get out of here. Here are the Larks, from Christmas to New Year's.
It's a long time from Christmas to New Year's, sweetheart, when you are not around. It seems as long as from June to December, sweetheart, when you are not around. Tell me, darling, please, without you, what will I do? It's a long time from Christmas to New Year, sweetheart, when you are not around.
Christmas to New Year's, featuring Alan Bunn, who left the band and changed his name to Tar Heel Slim. How does that work? Does he sit around with his fans? They say, hey guys, from now on I want you to call me Tar Heel Slim. Anyway, in this song, they say it's a long, long time from Christmas to New Year's. Actually, it's only 7 days. I guess that could seem like a long time. This seems like a long time. We're just doing 2 hours.
We're making a New Year's resolution to spread a little sunshine every day. So start now, we're wishing you a happy New Year all the way.
Here's some of the most popular New Year's resolutions. How many of these have you made? How many of these will you break? Number one, spend more time with family and friends. Recent polls show that more than 50% of Americans promise to appreciate loved ones and spend more time with family and friends this year. Number two, exercise more. Number three, lose weight. Number four, quit smoking. Number five, enjoy life more. I'm gonna try that one. Number six, quit drinking. Number seven, get out of debt. Number eight, learn something new. Well, that's easy if you keep listening to Theme Time Radio Hour. Number nine, help others and volunteer. Well, I think we talked about that. And number 10, I've got this somewhere around here. Oh, here it is. Get organized. But New Year's resolution is not a modern thing. You can track it all the way back to the Babylonians. According to research, the most popular resolution in early Babylonia was to return borrowed farm equipment. I wish Harold would bring back my lawnmower.
Hello, this is David Hidalgo from Los Lobos, and you're listening to Theme Time Radio Hour with Bob Dylan, and I'd like to wish you a happy new year and have yourself a happy little Christmas.
Nancy Wilson wants to know what you're doing on New Year's Eve. By the mid-60s, Nancy Wilson was the second biggest seller on Capitol Records. You know who number one was? That's right, Glenn Campbell. Nah, I'm just kidding. It was the Beatles. Here's Nancy Wilson asking the musical question, what are you doing New Year's Eve?
Maybe it's much too early in the game, but I thought I'd ask you just the same. What are you doing New Year's? New Year's Eve. One those arms will hold you good and tight. When it's exactly 12 o'clock that night, welcoming in the new year. I'm crazy to suppose I'd ever be the one you chose out of a thousand invitations you receive. But in case I stand one little chance, here comes the jackpot question in advance. What are you doing New Year's? New Year's Eve. But in case I stand one little chance,
that was Nancy Wilson. What are you doing New Year's Eve? Well, there's no shortage of drinking on New Year's Eve. Here's a few New Year's toasts. Here's to the bright new year and a fond farewell to the old and to the things that are yet to come and the memories that we hold. Here's another one. The new year is ringing in. May he be bringing in the good times we've waited for so long in vain. Without the demanding, all rise and drink standing. And so say we all of us again and again. Oh, here's a good one. Ring out the old, ring in the new. Ring happy bells across the snow. The year is going, let him go. Ring out the false and ring in the true.
The old year's gone and I'm all through. I'm turning this old world over to you.
I'm ready to go, brand spanking new. And I'm wishing a happy new year to all of you.
Well, one song more than any other is associated with New Year's, and that's Auld Lang Syne, which is Scottish for old long since. Although it might be better translated as old long ago, times gone by, or days gone by. It's a poem by Robert Burns, the poet laureate of Scotland, one of the best known songs in the world. In the Philippines, it's also sung at graduations. In the United Kingdom, it is played at the close of the annual Congress of Trades Unions. In Japan, many stores play it to usher customers out at the end of a business day. And in Portugal, Spain, and Germany, this song is used to mark a farewell. Should all acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should old acquaintance be forgot and auld lang syne? For auld lang syne, my dear, for auld lang syne, we'll take a cup of kindness yet for auld lang syne. And surely you'll get your pint mug, and surely I'll get mine. And we'll take a cup of kindness yet for auld lang syne. We two have run about the hills and pulled the daisies fine, but we've wandered many a weary foot since auld lang syne. We two have paddled in the stream from morning sun till dawn, but seas between us broad have roared, sinks Auld Lang Syne. And there's a hand, my trusty friend, and give us a hand of thine, and we'll take a right good friendly draught for Auld Lang Syne. It's been a great year being able to play records for you here at Theme Time Radio Hour. We're glad y'all are listening, and on behalf of all of us here at the Abernathy Building, we wish you the merriest, happiest, and healthiest holiday season. May you show kindness and receive kindness. Be careful. Don't become a holiday statistic, because we need you back here in 2 weeks on an all-new Theme Time Radio Hour. We'll see you next year.
You've been listening to Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan. Produced by Eddie Gorodetsky. Associate producer, Sonny Webster. Continuity by Eats Martin. Edited by Damian Rodriguez. Supervising editor, Rob McCumber. The Theme Time research team, Diane Lapson and Bernie Bernstein. With additional research by Lynn Sheridan, Kimberly Williams, and Robert Bauer. Production assistance by Jim McBeam. Special thanks to Randy Azradi, Debbie Sweeney, Coco Shinomiya, and Samson's Diner. For XM Radio, Lee Abrams. Recorded in Studio B, the Abernathy Building. Studio engineer, Tex Carbone. This has been a Greywater Park production in association with Big Red Tree. This is your announcer, Pierre Mancini, speaking. Join us again in 2 weeks for Theme Time Radio Hour, when the subject is Women's Names.